So this video is in continuation with the previous video that I shared, that is Excel session 7. I have shared it on April 15th. But for some reason, we could not record it after the break that I gave in that class. So I'm just recording this session for you. You can follow these. In this recording, I'm just going to show you how to create a dynamic chart, an interactive chart using form controls, and also pivot tables. So let me start off with it. A dynamic chart looks like this. When you choose all quarters here, so this is a chart that is displaying sales of all the quarters in a year. Now, based on the selection of the quarter that I provide, it has to highlight only that quarter, the series that belong to first quarter have to be colored. So not all of them. I have just selected here. You can see when I choose second quarter, only second quarter or third. So only those particular series are getting selected. We want to create a similar chart. Let's go here and select this range. I have the same data copied onto the next sheet, just to show you from the scratch how it is created. Now you have to select the data, go to insert, insert a clustered column chart, the basic clustered column chart. See? Once you do this, you go to view and remove those grid lines. Go to view, remove the grid lines so that it looks neat. So now I'm going to take the form controls from the developer tab, just click on it, go to insert, choose option button. That is the control that we want now. And please choose only from the form controls, not from ActiveX, okay? ActiveX controls work only when you program them. So now I'll choose option button and draw it. I require 5 option buttons. 1 option button for each quarter and all quarters. An option button to choose to, provide a selection for all quarters. So I'll make a copy of this and paste it 4 times. So you should remember the order of insertion is very important in case of an option button. That is going to decide the number of this particular option button that I choose. So you will understand it when we are using it in the formulas. So you need to align these option button like this. To choose the option button, see, if you just select it, it's not going to help. I will not be able to edit anything or move it. So in order to edit the option button or move it, you should make sure you hold control button and just press on it, it gets selected. So after you have placed all these option buttons in the same line, we are going to see how to change their names. Hold control, select the option button and edit the names. I'll give quarter one here and this one as quarter 2, and this as quarter 3. Over here we have an option button. For this side, rename it as quarter 4. And the last one I choose to give as all quarters. Let's say all. After I provide this, so now let's take care of the alignment part. I want all these option buttons to have equal distance between them and to be placed in the same line. So I go on format tab and choose that. Choose align option. Over here you have align middle. This helps me to put all these option buttons in the same line. And the next thing is distribute horizontally. Choose this option to give equal distance between the option buttons. After we are done with this, and just right click on any option button, and you get to see format control over here. You need to select this, and you need to provide a cell link. I'll tell you what is the cell link. Just say okay. See, the cell link is the only value that connects the data that we have and the option that button that we have provided. It is the only way in which I can connect the data and this option button selection. See, you just observe here. I choose quarter one, the value changes to one there. If I choose quarter four, it displays four. It is indicating the fourth option button has been selected. And I'll select all here. You can see it is five. So now, after we have provided this cell link, we should make the data work now. We have to see that in the chart, the data is plotted in the way that we want to see. So for that, I have to use a function and prepare the data for this. I have manually provided numbers to indicate which month belongs to which quarter. After I give this, I use if function, and you see, I'm going to take this cell, that's the cell link, and I'm going to compare the cell link value against the value that is there in the A column and say equal to A. If the cell link value is equal to the cell, then display sales value for that month. Else, LA error. This error has to be provided so that it doesn't get plotted. If you provide zero, it's still a number that can be plotted on the chart. Okay, after you give this, just drag it to other cells. Now you can see only quarter three values are being displayed. So as and when I change the selection in the option button, you can see even the numbers are changing there. If I choose all, the entire T column will display NA. So it is indicating no quarters have been chosen. Only not a specific quarter has been chosen. So now I want to use this data to plot on the chart. We have already used it, but only these two columns were selected. Now I'm going to include this column also. So select the chart, right click, choose select data. See, you just have to go and extend the selection to the next column also. And click OK. You can see now, depending on the quarter you select, the series are displayed. The extra series is being displayed. I don't want to see two separate series here. I would like to see it as a single series only. So just choose the series, any series, right click and say format data series. And say over here and say series overlap as 100%. So now both the series got overlap one on the other so that it will be visible like this works. Okay, is that clear? So this is known as dynamic chart. The next chart that I'm going to teach you is known as an interactive chart. Let me share the screen to you. So the chart that you are seeing currently is known as an interactive chart. How is it interactive? So you can see we have a data with sales, profit and profit percentage being displayed for these many years. Now I should be able to choose the series. So you can see here how it performs. I chose only sales and profit. Only those two series are visible on the chart. Now let's say I want to compare profit and profit percentage. Only those two will be visible, or either of them. You see, I gave only profit is being displayed. Now how to create this chart and how to make it work like this? Let's see it. And let's remove all these things. Okay, insert clustered column chart on this. Go to insert tab and choose clustered column. After you have inserted, okay, you can see here profit percentage series is not being visible on the chart. It is because of its value. The percentage value is too small to be compared against sales or profit value. For that, you right click on any of the series, right click on the series and say change series chart type. We select it, you can see here all are the clustered column format. I'll change this profit to line and I want to plot it on a secondary axis. So now it is visible to us. And I'll also change these charts to stacked column. So now I'm able to see all three series plotted on the chart. Now, if I have to choose among the series, I need to provide checkbox, which is available in the developer tab. Go to developer tab, take insert, within form controls. I repeat, within form controls. You need to choose from here only. I choose this checkbox and draw it. We have three series, so we need three checkboxes and align them in the same line. And after the aligning, and see that they are renamed. So this is for sales. And this is profit. And this is profit percentage. So you need to select all of these holding control and use this format tab to align them in a proper way. I'll first align them middle, then I'll distribute horizontally so that they have equal space among them. Now, again, for these checkboxes also, we need to provide cell link. But in the previous example that I showed, you just chose any particular option button and you gave a cell link. But in case of checkbox, you need to provide cell links separately. For each checkbox, you need to provide it. So where to provide it? We have a separate table on the right-hand side over here. So this table is a replica of what is there on the left-hand side. So this data is what I'm speaking of. It's the same data that we are seeing over there as well, but with some formulas. I'll say why we have taken this. Just right click on the checkbox. You will get format control and choose the cell link right on top of sales column. You repeat the same for profit and profit percentage checkboxes as well. Repeat the same process. And say okay. So once we are done with it, once we have provided the cell links, I'm going to use a if function. And I'll say if the above given cell value is true. So I'll keep the row absolute and say true. True is not a text, it's a logical value, so don't use double quotes for it. Now if it is true, then I have to display this one. Else in a error. Give that and just copy paste it to other cells. You can see the profit percentage is not visible. Just select and change the format to percentage, you'll be able to see the numbers. Once you're done with this, you should change the source of this chart data. So I should choose this table to plot it. The select data, go here. I'll choose it from here and say OK. So now you can see you will be able to choose the series on which you want to plot the chart. See, I'm plotting only profit percentage. Along with that, I want to see profit. It will be visible. And if I choose sales as well, it display like this. So you can use these check boxes in order to choose among the series that you want to plot. Okay. This is known as interactive chart, and the previous example was about a dynamic chart. So these are the special charts created out of the basic charts that we had already learned. So there is no rocket science here. It's only a very simple chart that we have used, and using that we are creating it. Okay. So the next topic is pivot tables. So just hold on for a second until I share the file with you. So pivot tables is a summarizing tool that we have in Excel. It's a boon, I can say, for those who don't know they are not well versed with functions that Excel provides. Then pivot tables is a really good option. So even otherwise, it's a really good option to summarize huge data. And it allows you to plot charts on the pivot table. Right? We'll be seeing all those things now. So first of all, in order to insert a pivot table, you need to choose the data. Choose the entire data. I am using a shortcut, Alt-N-V. This is a shortcut to get the Create Pivot Table window. So let me show you again, or I'll type it for you. It's Alt-N-V. You need to press these keys one after the other in sequence. You'll get the window for creating a pivot table. So over here it says select a table or range. We have already selected it. And the next thing is choose where you want to place your pivot table. Now it could be a new worksheet or an existing worksheet also. I recommend you to always choose a new worksheet. That will actually keep your reports as well as the data safer. What do I mean by that is, in case you want to increase your data, tomorrow your data got increased either column wise or row wise, so that should not force you to move your pivot table again. So it's better to keep it separate always. And say in the new worksheet and say, okay, we have a blank pivot table. A pivot table is ready. I just have to choose the columns based on which I am trying to prepare reports. So now let's say I want to quickly create report on region wise sales. I get it as soon as I select the columns. And you just have to choose from here. And these will go and sit in the appropriate fields. You don't have to worry about it. So you are seeing, currently you are seeing region wise sales, region wise subtotal of the sales value. Now you can add another column value to it. Now say I also want to see product wise along with the region wise data. So even that gets displayed. So it's so quick and swift, and the best part is it's very accurate also. It all depends what you have kept in your source data. Based on that, you're getting the reports here. Now, these reports are also flexible in formatting. Now, let's say I want to format it. Just go to design, keep your cursor on the pivot table and click on design tab. So you get so many options over here. I want to change the style of the pivot table that I have included. Let's say you have three types of themes available in the pivot table style. light, medium, and dark. You can choose among them. So what type of format that you want to apply. And I choose this. You can see here. It automatically has applied all the formats. Now, if you want to quickly send it to someone, but not as a pivot table, as some data, let's say. You just have to copy. Let me take another sheet here and try pasting it. But you should paste it as values first. So if you directly paste it, it becomes another pivot table, which we don't want. We are only interested in the values that are stored there in the report, and I want it as is with all the formats applied. I'll first paste it as values, and next I'll paste it as formats, and I'll also paste the column width. Now it is ready. This report is ready. You can just use the same to send a mail or something like that. So this saved a lot of time for you in applying formats, your calculation, all these things are saved. You can rely on these pivot tables for accuracy, and you can just send it. Send this report to anyone concerned. Now, if this is one advantage, the next thing is how to keep the report. Even in keeping your reports, you have a lot of flexibility provided. You have to go to design. So let me choose this. Go to design tab. So over here, you have report layout. How exactly your report has to be visible. Choose this. By default, your pivot tables will be in the compact form. Now, if you provide outline form, just observe what changes. Previously, region and product were in the same column. Now they are displayed in two different columns. And the group total is displayed on top of the group, top of each group over here. Now let's say I'll again choose a different, layout here, report layout, and just see the change. I'll choose tabular form. See, in tabular form, always the group total will be displayed below the group, and the next column's data starts from the same row. So that's the difference that you can make out in the tabular form. You also have few more things, few more layouts, like repeat all item labels. If you choose this, you can see the region values are repeating. You can remove them as well. Do not repeat item labels, it will not be repeated. And you also have an option to switch on and switch off subtotals and grand totals. Now if I say off for rows and columns, no grand total is displayed. Now you can switch off your subtotals also. You have permission to do this. And if you require, you can keep them as well. And you have an option to give a blank line after each item, that is after each group. If you wish to give a blank line, you can see here, insert blank line. A blank line is inserted after each group. So you can remove it also. So these are the things, okay, in applying the formats, these are really helpful. And see over here, currently I have only one column with the numerical data, for that this is being displayed. And by default, if you have any numerical data in a column and that column is selected to get displayed on the report, the default function uses the sum. If you want to change it, there are two ways. Right click on it, go to value field settings. This is one way, and another way is you could go to values field over here in the pivot table field section. Right click, you have a small arrow here. Click on it, you again get value field settings. So these are the two ways in which you can access the value field settings. Now I want to choose average, let's say. So it will display me average sales. In place of total sales, it will display me average sales. So you have option to choose from the list of functions available here. You can show the totals, subtotals or grand totals based on the function you choose here. So let me give some only. And you also have an option to change the format. Now for sales, let's say I want to display numbers with a currency symbol. I'll select this and go for accounting. Or you can also choose currency for that. And you can choose the symbol from here. Say okay. See, the data is formatted now. These numbers are displayed like this. Okay. So this is one thing that I wanted to show you. So I'll be showing you a small dashboard that we can prepare using pivot tables in Excel. So there I'll be showing you how to use slicers and timeline. I forgot to show you something with dates. So let me show you that also. See, within the same report, now suppose I want date-wise report. I'll choose date. So you can see by default, the dates are grouped as years, quarters, and month. So right, you just expand here, you can see it is arranged in this format. Now, right click on this, click on group. See, you have the option to change the grouping, how you want to see the data. Suppose I want to see month-wise sales. I will be able to do this. I'll just place this date in the column field. See? Or you could just place region in the column field. It's much better now. So you could also, right click on it, say group. You can also wish to display it as quarters. So you have various groupings like this. You can group them day wise also. You take group, you choose days. As soon as you choose days, you get this number of days. For how many number of days do you want to classify? So it also has a starting date and ending date. So between these two dates, how do you want to split the number of days? So if I say for 7 days, I would like to consider the data to be calculated. I'll just say okay. You see, for every 7 days from the starting date till the ending date, all the dates are split among 7 days. And for each week, you can see the values given here and arranged in region wise. So you have all these options to perform quickly using Pivot Tables. Otherwise, you would have to break your head sitting and giving those formulas and other things. So this really helps a lot, guys. You can use it. So next thing, as I said, I would like to show you a simple dashboard to be created using Pivot Tables. Let me remove all this and choose region. So this particular report is showing me region wise sales. Let me insert a column in the beginning. I'll just add a column here just for the sake of presentation, nothing else. So I'll make a copy of this Pivot Table. And I'll create a copy and create another Pivot Table with the same copy and another one else. So I have 3 separate Pivot Table reports. So I'll go here and change region to product. I'll remove it. And here I'll change it to customer type and I'll remove region. Now these are the 3 reports that I'm looking at. Now these 3 reports have to change based on the salesperson that I choose. So let's say if you have something like this in your mind, then we can use slicer and timeline to make it more dynamic. So first, let me show you how to insert pivot charts on these separate reports. Then I'll show you the use of slices and timeline. You just have to place your cursor in the report that you have created. Go to analyze. You have something known as pivot chart over here. You should just click on it. You will get a lot of charts displayed here to choose among. I'll choose column chart for the first report. And see, you have these filter buttons given and also the field buttons with legend and all these values. So you can remove few things to, you know, reduce the size of your chart. Say hide all field buttons on chart and remove the axis here. I also don't require a legend. And over here, I can change the chart title. Let's say region wise. Sales. So you can just say region wise sales. And I'll keep just below this report and reduce the chart size. Fine. So you also have the provision to. You also have the provision to display data labels. Right click on this, just say data labels, you will get it. Okay, so the next thing is for this part, let me increase the column width. So for this report again, I'm going to take analyze tab, insert a pivot shape chart for this. Over here, I'll choose pie for it. I'll use a pie chart, and again over here, I'll remove the buttons and also the legends. And here, I'll change the chart title to product wise sales. Later, just right click on the series and say add data labels. It will be displayed, but along with it, let's say, along with it, I would like to see the name of these products. I'll choose format data labels. Here you could choose. I'll say category name has to be displayed and percentage. I'll remove the value. So this is done. And you could also format your chart that you have already provided. You could also change it this way. Yes, this looks much better. I'll remove the legends here. And I'll reduce the chart size to accommodate here, just below the report. Align it properly and we are done with it. The next report that we have, even for this, I'm going to insert another pivot chart. So let me choose, let's say a bar chart for this. A line chart would be a very small one, only one series. So now I'll remove this field buttons, no legend. I don't require this and give that here. You can also choose to reduce the chart size. And change the report name over here. Say customer type. So now we have the reports ready with all the charts being displayed here. So I'll remove the grid lines also. So now it looks perfect. Next thing that we have to do here is add slicer. So slicer is used for filtering purpose, guys. Slicer or timeline, it is used for the slicing the data. So slicing means filtering the data. Choose insert slicer. You need to choose based on which column you are giving the slicer. And select salesperson name and say okay. You can also change the format of the slicer to match your data. I'll choose this. Okay, it looks much better now. I'll also choose timeline. Timeline is an option used for filtering only dates. If you have a column of dates in your data, timeline can be used to filter only dates. So now even this has been formatted to match your dashboard. Next thing, you should check whether the slicer and the timeline are connected to all the reports given here. Right click. So you have report connections selected. Only per table one is selected. You just have to select the other tables also, so that based on the selection that you perform, you can see all three of them are changing here. All three reports are changing. So right click on this again, you have report connections. Even for timeline you have it. You just have to select the pivot tables and say okay. See, even here you can choose to filter based on the quarters. Now suppose, let's say I want to choose quarter 3 of 2008 or quarter 2 of 2009. So you can't compare both separately. It should be a continuous data. In timeline I can't choose two separate quarters belonging to two separate years. That's not possible. It should be a continuous data. So these are the things that you can perform. So this is all about the pivot tables. Okay. Thank you all, guys. So you can check for the videos for all the sessions that I have shared along with this video. So this was half of the class which we could not record. Okay, it is in continuation with the session 7 link that we have, session 7 video that I have already posted it on April 15th.